Great to see everybody out tonight. You know, in 1998, I was sitting at home and I got a call from the Junkyard Dog. We had gone back for years as friends. One of those relationships where we didn't talk about a lot of wrestling. We sat in the dressing room and we shared pictures of our kids and talked about our lives and how we were raised. He was just a genuinely good human being. A week after I got that call, Buddy Landell and I spoke at his funeral. He was a special man, and I miss him to this day. He was instrumental in a lot of the folks here learning their craft and getting GCW up and going. He is the heart and soul of Global Championship Wrestling. Tonight, we honor him once again with this JYD Tag Team Tournament. And in this tournament, you're going to see some of the greatest independent wrestling stars, tag teams that you will see anywhere in the world. I come down here because I'm the commissioner. Before I came here, I came as a fan and bought a ticket because, by God, this is the best show that you will find anywhere.
It's an event.
I'll turn it back over to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, let me hear it for the Bomber, Jack Lord.
Underway already. They wasted no time. Your GCW Tag Team Champions wasting no time. Prowler and Muddbone on Scotty Boys. Throwing Big K to the outside. Bernie's already lost control of this match. And we need to state, if somehow Scotty and Big K win this, they will be the new GCW Tag Team Champions.
The current champions, Muddbone and NightProwler, double teaming Scotty Blaze, Big K outside the ring. Nope, backflip, out comes off the rope, sets and double clothesline takes him down.
The vicious Vanguard are down.
Nice. You went with it. I'm proud. I'm happy.
Scotty,
I don't get that many often.
Scotty Blaze and Big K standing tall against the GCW Tag Team Champions. Who would have thought? Where's Jacob? What is Scotty Blaze doing out of here with Big K? When did this happen?
Okay, there have been a lot of things happening behind the scenes. You're originally supposed to be Big K and Jack Gunn, Scotty Blaze, and the Kryptonite Killer, Michael Steele. We've had some situations take place behind the scenes. These two gentlemen, after finding out what happened to the respective tag team partners, went to each other and say, hey, you want to give it a shot? Let's go for it. What have we got? Everything in front of us. We got a chance to win this thing and a chance to get the tag team titles.
How do you know this information? You're not a journalist.
No, I'm the special liaison to the commissioner. I learned these things. I pay attention. Plus, I am a broadcast journalist. Monsoon.
I went to college for broadcast journalism. I never saw you there. Big shout out to JSU. Look at Scotty in his green. Look.
Big shout out to UAB. Go Blazers, 2017 football. See you there.
Go Cox. The Gamecocks.
I know. Jacksonville State University. I know.
You know. We're seeing around the world. Now, you look at Prowler. Prowler. Oh. And come in. Jump, Scotty. Through Big K. And now who's on the offensive? Scotty.
Scotty has.
Disqualify them, referee. Bernie needs to disqualify Prowler. He put his hands on an official.
GCW senior official Bernie Kawana.
It's a $50 fine.
Yeah, it is. Collar and elbow tied, middle of the ring, going for the wrist lock, swinging around. Quick kick to the midsection, clubbing shot to the back of the shoulders. Tag mate.
Maybe he shouldn't have done that. Scotty should have stayed in this entire time. Why would he tag Big K in?
Big K has come quite a ways.
He's trying.
The trying can only get you so far.
But you don't want to stay that close to Muddbone. Fortunately, tag mate, double sledge takes him out.
Big K and Scotty Blaze gelling like a real tag team. What is this? Is this Bizarro World?
Yes, it is. I'm used to it. Me Bizarro, you Bizarro. Hard slam. Scotty.
Moonsault.
Nice. One.
Vintage Scotty Blaze.
And notice, Nightcrawler was ready to make his way in. May have had a little bit of doubt about the resiliency of his tag team partner for a second there.
100% correct on that, sir.
Big K tagged back into the match. Set.
You would have thought these guys have wrestled together 1,000 times.
Exactly.
Big K is bringing it up. Big K is ready for the JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament.
You know, this time of year brings out the best in everybody, especially because, okay, we are taking everything sequentially live here on a Saturday night, February the 25th. Hold on. And Muddbone able to take back over just that quickly. Of course, that's actually the first sustained offense Bone has had in this match.
Besides the jumping at the beginning, of course. I mean, yeah. I think they were both confused that Scotty Blaze was out here with Big K. Kidney shots. That's old vintage and a throwback on Prowler's behalf.
Oh, yeah.
All the way from Hell's Kitchen. Do you see those rights? Right in the kidney, right in the kidney. Oh, rake of the eyes.
I'm getting a message in the headset. I'll be back in just a minute.
Prowler is on top now. Big K gave him that inch and they took a mile. Shots in the corner. Big K. Big K needs to shovel himself together. Cover up. Oh, Scotty trying to make the save. Bernie having a heck of a time trying to keep these men out. Oh, there was no tag. Get a half behind Bernie's back. Will Bernie allow this? Bernie allowing the tag behind his back. Bernie is slipping. Come on, Bernie. As Q-Tip said, get it together.
I haven't heard that reference in a while. By the way, hi, I'm back. Whoo!
Hung him out to dry.
In a bad way. The viciousness of the Nightcrawler. This man has an attitude like you wouldn't believe. And if you think he's hell in the ring, try passing him in the hallway. He's the only person I know that would make you want to go 3 blocks over to leave the same hallway as him.
You know, he met Pope Francis about 3 months ago. He crop dusted him.
I got nothing on that one.
He did. That's how vicious he is.
It is. Big K trying to fight back.
Maybe not the best against Muddbone.
If you want to see another vicious streak, tick off Mud. Oh, got him.
What a clothesline. That clothesline may have knocked Big K out.
Kowanowicz got a one.
No. Oh, Scotty now making the save. Scotty knew Big K was not going to kick out of that. And he pays for it. Scotty trying to get it. Bernie trying to keep this match together. Elbow, that'll bust you open.
Kowanowicz questioning whether or not there was a tag. Fall away headbutt. Or diving headbutt, however you want to put it.
I think Big K is just running off fumes. It's instinct at this point. They had him. They were so close. And all it took is that little bit. And the vicious vanguard on top of him.
Tag made. The Mystic from San Monique. A gentleman that your tag team, the Violent Gentleman, has had some run-ins with, and then, unfortunately, for a short period of time, fell under the control of.
That they did, and now that contract is null and void. Well, we all know everyone's just fighting for second place anyways in this tournament. My tag team will be the JYD Memorial Tag Team Champions.
Brute.
I promise you that. The trophy and the titles are coming with the Wicked Nexus.
The man who has had the Midas touch in the JYD Memorial for a number of years, and I'm referring to my broadcast colleague, the Wicked Nemesis.
5 out of 7 years.
Matter of fact, I want to say a happy, depending on when this airs, happy birthday to the primal Chris Knox.
Oh, Chris. Oh. Oh, boy. You got to know. Chris Knox, Damon Christopher, then Chris Knox and Damon Christopher, and then Chris Knox and Clyde Braddock.
Yep.
It's a hell of a thing. Tag team wrestling is a beauty. It's an art form that very few want to dabble. They're painting with water paint. When it comes to this tournament, myself, every tag team that I'm associated with, and which this will be a different tag team that has won it for me, I'm telling you, we're painting with blood. Our canvas is right there in front of you, people.
I have a way or a phrase that I've been using for a number of years, as you've just witnessed a vicious two-on-one from Muddbone and Nightprowler on Big K Holmes. He made the art reference just a second ago. When it comes down to it, and the art form of tag team wrestling in the JYD, yes, Wick would be Rembrandt, the one who leaves everyone else in a Rem state.
That is amazing. I'm putting that on a shirt. Schmidt, can you get on that? Get me a shirt. The crowd solidly behind Scotty Blaze and Big K. I think they're chanting Harriet Tubman. I hear that, Harriet Tubman.
He's over on the left-hand side, the right-hand side of your screen.
1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
Same address I used for the last 20 years.
And I just used it the last 2 minutes. Boom. Big K trying to come back. Big K is feeding off this crowd. This crowd is solidly behind them.
You know, they talk about the sixth man in basketball, the 12th man in football. Lo and behold, the power of this crowd, the energy. Here you go. Back elbows looking to create the distance. Big K, hard shot to the head. Make it two. Trifecta. Take that, MC. Rapid fire reaction from Big K Holmes. Ooh, oh, blocked.
Oh, no.
You hesitated.
Caught his punch, and he caught his punch.
Swing and a miss. Comes in. Shoulder block. Nothing happening there. Big K back off the other side. Shoulder block. Staggered him. Make it three. No.
Power slam. Done, son.
Floats over. No.
Scotty, get out. Get out. Disqualify them. There should be two disqualifications. Scotty keeps interfering, breaking up this pinfall. What are you doing, Scotty? Have more faith in Big K.
And believe it or not, Prowler backing away while Mudbone tees off on Big K. Big K had to go. Oh, throwing that elbow in for him all over again. Can he get out of that corner? Can he? Up. One for the Prowler. One more for Bone. Back elbow. Four shots. Ping pong.
They're just lucky that Prowler.
Tag
or Mudbone doesn't use Mudbone's cane.
And Scotty Blaze. The
house of fire.
I was about to say.
I know you were. I stole it out from you. Those drop kicks. You know that man bench presses 400 pounds.
It
can
easily
do the Rob Van Dam split. Only seven people in the world can do that.
Blaze goes to the top. Wait a minute.
Do we have a changing of the guard?
Double crossbody. Got him. And this crowd has come unglued. Tag made. Holmes making his way back in. That may have been a little bit too soon in my book. Splash into the corner. Double splashes in stereo, if you will. Big K lined up. Caught him.
Ooh, he better stay on him. This is those shots. Mudbone has something playing. Look at him. Oh, he snatches Scotty Blaze down.
Wait a minute. Brings him up.
Choke slam.
Got him. One, two for the win. Three. Got it.
Ah, so close yet so far away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the fallen match and still your GCW Tag Team Champions and moving to the second round of the JYD Memorial, the Nightprowler and the Mystic Mudbone.
And the chaos ensues after the fact. Bone and Prowler were not thrilled in the least.
Tonight, the Violent Gentleman gets MadDog Dan Sawyer and the real deal, AJ Steele. AJ, we respect you. You know you're one of us, but tonight, you're just gonna be another victim, because tonight, in Pell City, is the end of you. This is where it all ends. It ends tonight. Tonight is going to be refreshingly violent. And just remember one thing, Mad Dog. You put yourself in this position. We're just stepping it up. This will be 5 out of 7 years I have led a tag team, a different tag team, to the JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament victory. The gold's coming with us. And I promise you this, of all the things you've ever known in your life, there's only one constant. There's only one thing you need to know. Tonight, someone is going to bite the bullet.
Junkyard Dog Tag Team Tournament. It means a lot to the Mad Dog because the Junkyard Dog put me in this business in 1990. So this is what it's all about. The greatest tag teams in the world coming together. Violent Gentlemen, looking good, except for your manager. I'm gonna say this. I'm impressed with you young men. But know this, this is a big tournament that means a lot to me. I'm gonna bite like a crocodile and kick like a mule. But let me tell you, I got a partner tonight. Some call him the tank, some call him the juggernaut, but I call him the real deal, AJ Steele!
Ladies and gentlemen, this match in the opening round of the 2017 JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament, the Violent Gentlemen taking on MadDog Dan Sawyer and AJ Steele, your referee for this matchup, GCW senior official Bernie Kumanowitz.
This could get very volatile very quickly. For those of you that were listening to GCW Radio this past Tuesday night, you heard an exchange between Mr. O'Hagan and Dan Sawyer. And this is going to be one of those circumstances where I don't know where Sawyer's head genuinely is. Because O'Hagan said some things that sparked Sawyer. Bell sounds, here we go. The tank, the juggernaut, the real deal, the usual suspect. I'll get them all out of the way in one shot. Play a little game with the world bearer, Scott Morgan. Fast Eddie Lane, Shane Knowles, ringside with Global Championship Wrestling. Duck under, go behind. Steel off. Andrews able to move, comes in. Ooh, ooh. Refreshingly violent. Oh, wow.
I was going to say, be very smart of the gentleman to use speed and tag team maneuvers on AJ Steel. Backfired in a hurry. Back to the drawing board, Eddie.
Just a little bit. That's why I always use dry erase. Size, strength, experience advantage. However, the experience as a team does not go to Sawyer and Steele, who I want to give full credit to my tag team partner on Beyond Ringside Live, Mark Mabo Doman, for saying that Sawyer and Steele should have come out to the nickname Steel Dogs tonight.
It's been very appropriate in the region. Uh-oh, he tells us all to hush it up.
Yes, you heard me say that. AJ, love you, brother. You can do better than that.
I think he heard you.
Sorry, Scott. you're about 40 feet away from the ring. Cross court, up and nope. Up and bye-bye.
Excedrin headache number 9 right there. Scott Morgan.
See, I told you Shane would fit in perfectly around here. Into the corner hard. Have a seat. Take a load off. Now vacation's over.
And you know it's not lost on all the teams that are in the field this year for the JYD Memorial. If you win this, it puts you on the map. There can only be one. And I was not privy to the information that AJ Steele was going to be Mad Dog's partner, but if I were a betting man, I think I found my favorite team.
For entertainment purposes only. Thank you, Dan Patrick and Keith Olbermann. Sawyer working the wrist, working the arm. One of the 5 major points of articulation in play, takes it up and over to the hammerlock. Now, see, here's the scenario in play, and I got to be real about this. The gentlemen, refreshingly violent, are not afraid to clip or cut or buzzsaw through the corners. But very well respected by the fans here in GCW. Tag mate, the Irredeemable. Ayden Andrews making the tag in, coming in straight to work on that wrist and that arm. The part that I love about this is if you know what you're doing on this one, and most vets will know that I'm coming back, and longtime fans will see that, when you are able to torque the arm at that angle, it not only works on the wrist and the fingers, but the elbow and the shoulder. So it's kind of like you get a fire sale, 9 for 1.
It puts the arm at an unnatural position in a way it's not supposed to bend. So.
Sawyer sets.
Are you ready?
And the do-rag actually made it 5 minutes. Wait a minute. Nope. The World Bearer Scott Morgan able to come in and break up that panic attempt.
Was there a over-under on how long the rag would last?
Just varies. Steel. Having been gone for quite a while from Global, swinging a miss on the clothesline. Comes in!
Uh-oh.
Hooks a leg, rolls back, count of 1, count of barely a 2.
Always the highly respected official, Bernie, I have some problems with his last name.
Kowanowicz.
Kowanowicz, thank you.
Well, just wait for Christmas time to roll around. It goes Kowanzowicz, I kid you not. And here's the part that I think Sawyer and Steele need to worry about a little bit, actually quite a bit. Morgan and Andrews are dedicated inside the gym. Swing and miss on the clothesline. Comes up, springboard. Oh, caught him with that elbow.
Nicely done.
And a little advantage like that is all you need in this circumstance, right, Shane?
That's it. Window of opportunity just open right now, and capitalizing on it, they are.
Short range drop kick, lower midsection. Comes up, flying jalapeno, make it 2.
Very wise for the gentleman to keep AJ Steele in their corner and keep him grounded, because if he is on his feet, he is a load to him.
Oh, God, yes. Morgan back in. Oh, got to be careful on that. Now, granted, you're going to get the impact from, but you're also going to. And Andrews, of course, pressing the advantage. Sawyer falling right into that trap.
I don't blame Bernie here. He's trying to get both men out of the ring.
Now, the point I was going to make a minute ago is the simple fact that these two gentlemen, the violent gentlemen, very deceptively strong. If you have ever seen these two in the gym, they will move some furniture. And granted, big difference between it being in a controlled environment like the gym and being in a full-scale match. Yes. Sawyer and Steele fight back. The weights don't always fight back. Not even a 1. Okay, you got a one. Thank you, Bernie. Tag made to Morgan. Excellent. Leans back. Count of one. Count of two.
I like what I see from the Violent Gentlemen as they have this near advantage, but
that's I spoke too soon. Steele tried to sneak one in there. Kind of hard to picture AJ Steele being sneaky.
You're right. That's not an adjective I've used ever to describe AJ Steele.
Former GCW champion. Man has been a champion just about everywhere he has gone. All the way around the Southeast, including Peach State.
As I say, wherever he goes, accolades are sure to follow.
Sawyer, of course, no stranger to gold. Former GCW Tag Team Champion multiple times. Just recently lost the belts to Muddbone and NightProwler. Also, former heavyweight champion. Sawyer, of course, I don't think he wants to challenge for the middleweight title. But I will say the man has gotten himself in remarkable condition over the last couple of just tremendous strides. My hat's off to you, Daniel.
I'd say I'm proud to see how Mad Dog's looking these days. Looking sharp.
Oh! Caught him more with the shin than with the foot. Nicely played. Andrews rolls him over. Got a one for the win.
At this point, you've got to start asking, Eddie, what's it going to take to put AJ Steele away? A few men have done it.
You got to press the advantage. Based on an earlier statement I started to make, the advantage as far as teaming goes to the gentleman. Oh, shot fired. Up and whoop. Wick almost had to call for the fair catch. Oh, caught him jumping in Zaguri. Andrews up. Flying knee caught him, and how? Did he? No, he didn't. The resiliency of the real deal, the usual suspect, AJ Steele, always there.
Remarkable how much gas he's still got left in the tank. They've hit him with a flurry here in the last 5 or 6 minutes.
Everything but the kitchen sink, and give Wicked Nemesis enough time, he'll go find a kitchen sink.
Look at the strength of Ayden.
Oh, tag made. Morgan up. And took full advantage. I think Steele was bewildered for a second there. Leans back. Count of one for the win. That close.
Those pinfall attempts are getting closer and closer each time, Eddie. And Mad Dog Dan Sawyer, fresh as a daisy right now, would love the opportunity to get the squared circle again.
Shot fired by Morgan brings him up. There's that strength I was talking about, but Steele able to change his positioning. Up and flat. Andrews up and back.
These Violent Gentlemen splattered all over the ring here.
Morgan with the presence of mind to hold on. Can Steele make it over? Tag made.
There it is.
Sawyer, sledge, caught. Make it two. Lines him up coast to coast, stacking him up like cordwood. And what is Wick doing? Oh, wait a minute.
No. Claiming Mad Dog tripped on the tough rope. We got a chair in the ring?
Wick, really?
What?
Wait a minute.
This is right in front of the official.
But deliberation between Morgan and Andrews. I don't think they... No, they don't want to use... Wait
they
a minute.
They don't want it.
Sawyer rolls him up. Three.
Oh, my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, and advancing in the 17th annual JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament, the combination of AJ Steele and Mad Dog Dan Sawyer.
Lady, we know who our winners are, but we've got more questions than answers at this point.
Exactly true, Shane. A day of reckoning, kind of, sort of. Andrews and Morgan didn't want to use the chair. And Wick isn't really used to having people question in that regard because of his experience. Hold on.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the winners of the match and advancing in the JYD Memorial, Mad Dog Dan Sawyer and the Real Deal AJ Steele.
Say, not accustomed to seeing anyone go against their protege.
What are you two doing? You had him. No, you always said you. I gave you the chair. We had the tag team titles won. You should have used the chair. You don't get that opportunity all the time. Not against AJ Steele. Maybe against Mad Dog. Not against AJ. You shut up! Yeah, you had it and you lost it! Every time, you guys are the best tag team, I'm trying to make you even better!
Gentlemen, wicked. Oh! Now, this has gotten a bit out of hand. What?
Mr. O'Hagan, the extinction level event, Logan Creed, Brooklyn Page Creed, and annihilating the violent gentleman.
This situation has went from crazy to just flat out bonkers.
Irish necktie got him, sorry, my bad.
Oh, you're fine. I'm not used to seeing a tag team go against their manager's wishes and then to, oh my gosh.
I use the, wait a minute, brings him up. And that will register on the seismograph. What can you say in this regard? A new alliance? Hold on.
Surely to God, all of these people weren't in cahoots together. You've got to be kidding me. The extinction level event, Logan Creed, along with Mr. O'Hagan and Brooklyn Creed are together with the Wicked Nemesis? Eddie, I'm flabbergasted. This would all seem to be in cahoots.
A brand new alliance in play, but I have to question how deep the rabbit hole runs. O'Hagan, Creed, Brooklyn, and now the Wicked Nemesis on board. And the violent gentleman laid to waste. Hang tight. There is more from the JYD Memorial and more from Global Championship Wrestling.
The JYD Tournament is here. And everyone thinks, oh, JYD, it's time for the Great Tag Team Tournament. No, not tonight. Tonight, I put to bed any speculations that I am the best middleweight in the state of Alabama and the Southeast. I am the best middleweight. Lightning struck once last show. It's not going to strike again. I won't allow it. I will do everything in my power to prove that to me, to everyone in the Southeast, that I am the best middleweight that you could find. Joey Lydon, don't be in my way, because a storm's not going to stop this, Mama Joe. When I hit you with the Indie Killer, it's going to be over. Charles Zanders is coming for you.
Now, I've been getting asked questions over and over. Joey, why? Why did you attack Charles Zanders? Why did you come from behind like that? Well, you know what? Let me tell you a little story. Because this is, you know, JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament. Come on, let's give it up, man. Tag Team Tournament, yeah. Shut up! Stop clapping. Because what you're looking at is a two-time JYD Tag Team winner. Maybe you don't remember. I am the one that carries tag teams. I am a five-time tag team champion. You know what I've got out of that? Zero title shots. No world title shot, no middleweight title shot. So you know what I decided to do? I said, I am going to not only become champion, I am gonna prove to every last one of you that I am the best middleweight, not just in GCW, but the whole entire world. So Charles, why don't you come out here and do the right thing and just give the real champ the belt? Why waste these people's time? Because we already know. Hashtag title life, hashtag fear the lightning, because honestly, when I start, I'm not going to stop. So when you come out here, no, don't cheer me. Stop it. I don't need your claps. I don't need any of your claps. Where was it when I was trying to get title shots? Nowhere. So what you're going to do, I'm going to put this mic now, Charles. You come out here and you hand me my belt. Look me in the eye. You hand me my title.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, this match laid in one fall, 30-minute time limit for the GCW Middleweight Championship. Joey Lightning challenging Charles Zanders, your referee for this championship match, Brandon Cash.
Once a beloved and very popular figure in global championship wrestling, now he says he doesn't want the adoration. He doesn't want the jubilation. He doesn't want the cheers. Because he says the fans weren't there for him like he was for them. Welcome to the opening round of the JYD Memorial Tag Team Tournament Global Championship Wrestling in Bell City, Alabama. I am Fast Eddie Lane, being joined by the one and only Wicked Nemesis. What's up, Wick?
But was Joey incorrect? He's not incorrect.
I do not believe he is factually challenged. One-on-one encounter. Thank you to everybody who
what
is
high face.
Here in the Pell City Civic Center and a return by.
You know, Charles Zanders ran 4 miles this morning to get ready for this match. 4 miles. When was the last time he ran 4 miles?
Shades of the discus punch by Kerry Von Erich on that last shot.
He is ready. I hope Joey's ready, because this may be the best middleweight championship match that we have seen in some time.
And we've both been watching Joey Lightning quite regularly since his return to GCW. He has been making great positive strides, right, Wick?
Joey Lightning used to ride up and down the roads with Orion Bishop, Corey Hollis, Mike Posey, Johnny Slaughter, and myself. He needs to be on his A-game tonight, because I'm telling you, Charles Zanders is definitely going to be here on his A-game. I promise you that.
Whoop, caught the kick, comes back. All the way to be it.
Joey smartly rolls to the ring, gets out of a pinning predicament.
Nope, block comes back in, swinging a miss on the clothesline. Zanders up and hot. Fair catch called. To the backbreaker and drives him straight down.
That could be it. That is, Joey is on fire. He's caught lightning in the bottle twice now.
My compliments on that one. Pinning attempt in the ring. Count of one, count of two. And Cash was right there.
Well, that is not on the referee. Joey has got to pull an eye, pull that blonde hair, do something to the male model, Charles Zanders.
That'll do. That'll definitely be a start.
Or you may just make him mad. Look at him. He's got to take what he's doing right now. He's got to get closer on him. Stay on him. If he does not stay on Charles Zanders, this could spell disaster. All that the Joey Lightning talk means nothing if he does not bring it to Charles Zanders.
Zanders looking to turn it around. Hard shots.
Oh!
Impact with that knee.
I guess he needs to relax and go to it.
Brings up.
The stretch.
Thought he was going to go up and over, but no, went for the abdominal stretch.
One of my favorite moves, abdominal stretch. Not used enough in professional wrestling nowadays. Old school.
Now brings him up. Backbreaker.
That was the lower part of the back. Now he has worked the back totally. He has to stay on it. He's picked a body part, and he is sticking with it, as he should. Joey Lightning has never carried a division, even though he is a five-time champion with Doom, Trevor Eon. It doesn't matter. This is about the middleweight championship right here, right now in Pell City.
Brandon Cash ordering Lightning to back up. Xander's very slow to get back up. A little light on that shot to the upper back, but it served its purpose.
Now he's working upper back and lower back. He needs to pick one to stay with. But a man that's run 4 miles, a man that has added.
Wait a minute.
There's a cover at one, two, only a two count. Almost ended right there.
Forearm shot.
Look at those lights and those shoes. I hope that he has brought enough battery
himself. Snapped it off.
He better have brought that battery for his heart instead of just those shoes, because it's going to take everything. There you go, exchanging blows.
Lines him up, sends, nope, reversal by Lightning. Xander's off the ropes, comes in. Backbreaker again. Remembering what has gotten him the most success. Count of one, count of two.
If Joey hits the Lightning Bolt, it's over.
Yep.
If Xander's hits the Indy Killer, it is over. Both these men very well scouted, very well versed. Joey, about seven more years in the business than Charles. However, Charles has been on quite the roll. After capturing the title from O'Hagan, now Darth Hagan, this is going to be a barn burner. Can we say that without getting put on terrorist watches?
Sure. Lightning maybe taking a little bit. Open-handed slap straight down the chest.
Maybe taking too much time, Eddie. I heard what you were about to say.
Lightning working a very methodical pace this evening. And with Zanders, that's a smart thing because you slow him down. Because if you let Zanders control the pace, immediate advantage right there. Lightning lines up, coming in. No.
Charles setting himself up, running in place.
Lands on his feet.
Nope. Look at that. Very well scouted. A kick to the head. You see that?
They had each other
tick
scouted
for tack.
Up and...
Vaulting clothesline will knock you down every time. We've even seen Logan Creed, 7 foot tall Logan Creed, be taken out like that.
Yep. Comes in, hooks the leg, count of one, count of two. Get a buzzer sound effect for that.
I feel like seeing Purple Rain in Joey's shoes.
And if we were in the middle of a fog, it would be a purple haze.
Thank you, Mr. Hendricks.
One of the greatest of all time.
One of the best. The greatest, Jerry the Kiss. Oh, clothesline. Charles rocking and reeling Bob Aran on this one. Joey's going to have to do something drastic.
Swing and a miss. Lightning's got him tied up a little bit. Drove him down.
Lightning bolt. This is a lightning bolt. This should be it. Oh, look at the frustration in Joey Lightning's face.
He should have gone right for the pin. Right there. He could have had him.
He should have had him. He hit the lightning bolt and nothing. Joey, you're taking too long.
Wait a minute. Rolls him through. Hooks it. Two, three, got it!
Wow, by any means necessary.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the fall of the match, and still your GCW middleweight champion, Charles Zanders.
Your winner, by pinfall, Charles Zanders. Charles Zanders in control of this, dominating the middleweight division. Who can stop Charles Zanders? No one can stop Charles Zanders at this point.